Hello, this is Timo Tolkki of Stratovarius.
And Jens Johansson of Stratovarius.
And you are watching Masa Ito's Rock City.
Marilyn Manson は一回ショーケースでしか来てないからね。ちゃんとしたそのフルショー、シアトリカルな、本当にマリリン・マンソンの真髄が体験できるような、そういう日本公演を今回期待したいですよね。さて、ストラトバリウスのインタビューを早速紹介しましょう。9月26日、デスティニーを発表するストラトバリウスのティモ・トルキとイェンス・ヨハンスンが来日しました。何しろ今回のアルバムはね、アルバムタイトル曲のデスティニー、1曲目が10分以上あるからね。そういう意味ではね、聞き応えもあるし、そしてこのアルバムの背景にあるもの、それも逆に気になります。まずはインタビューのパート1をご覧ください。
今回のニューアルバム「デスティニー」のレコーディングで一番苦労したのはどういう点ですか？
カバー。
Really? I think.
Well, it was very easy. I think whole process was quite easy this time. You know, I don't know why. Maybe that was the best.
Because it was short.
It was quickly.
Yeah.
It was different in a lot of ways from the previous recordings. This record was. Well, first of all, the song material is more simple, easier to record and arrange. So, I mean, it was very easy process.
No demo?
Yeah, no demo as well. Straight to the studio.
Fresh.
その楽曲がシンプルだっていうのはレコーディングするつまり曲作りする前から今回のニューアルバムもシンプルでいこうというふうに考えてたんですか、それとも完成したものがシンプルだったということですか。
サブ完成したもの。It's difficult to say. Nothing when I write is intentional. Everything what comes out is what comes out. In this moment when I have the time.For composing the songs, then they come out. Before that, I don't think about it. And so it's not like I will think on tour that now I will compose all the songs in March or something. I don't do that.
じゃあその、ストラトバリウスの、まあ、曲というのは過去の曲が非常に緻密で非常にその起伏に富んだ曲が多かったわけですよね。まあ、今回 SOS だとか4000 Rainy Nights のように非常にシンプルだけどインパクトのあるものになったと。これどうしてですか。
Well, maybe subconsciously we needed a change a bit of something. And, but then again, it wasn't planned, you know. So again, for me, it's just a collection of songs I wrote in January. And I never.Like plan what kind of songs I'm writing. I'm just writing them, and then whatever comes out, then that's it. You know? And I think it's fresh if there are some new kind of new ideas, you know, on the record. So it's not like you're making the same record every year. That's a bit boring. You have to have some element, you know, which you change them.
イェンスね、今その曲が非常にシンプルになったというようなこともティモは言っていましたけど、キーボード奏者としてシンプルな曲にキーボードを入れるのは難しいですか。やっぱりシンプルが ゆえに簡単なんですか、どっちなんでしょう
か。 I think it's the same. You have to apply the same amount of care really. And, so it's always difficult. You know, in a way it's difficult in some way and simple in some other way. For me it's simple. Some other people might think it's very difficult. But I think there are also, although it might not be very technically difficult parts on this record, maybe like still it was difficult to make it fit, you know. So I think it's about the same, really. Doesn't matter if it's less technical, but it's still difficult.
このデスティニーをどう訳すかだね。運命だとか宿命だとかいろんな意味があるだろうけど、ティモ・トルキの話を総合するとね、彼のそのお父さんやお母さん、家族の問題だよね。自分の生き方というのは本当に自分自身が貫いてきたのか、それともお父さんやお母さんや、まあ、誰かによって決められた運命を歩んできたのか、そういう自身の葛藤みたいなものがね、相当アルバムにはね強く打ち出されてるみたいだね。これはねティモもあんまり詳しく言わないから、ブックレットの日本の歌詞をね、日本語訳を見てティモ・トルキが何を表現しているのか、 それをねちょっとチェックしてみるのもいいんじゃないですかね、さあインタビューのパート2をご覧ください。
あのティモは、自分のその歌詞を書くときにね、自分のこの世界に入っちゃうと非常に宗教的な歌詞になってしまうんだということを以前、言っていましたけど、今回の歌詞についてはどうですか？
Are they religious? I don't think they are religious. I mean,
well, maybe they are. Think about it. But I mean, it's new religion. Yeah. Inventing.
I mean, of course, in this year, I have changed a lot also the way I think. And of course, you can hear it from this in this lyrics as well. You know? I don't consider it as a religion because religion itself is not, it's not a positive thing, you know, such as I think everybody should find their way, what they believe in, not like what others tell them to believe in, you know. And it's a dangerous road, because if you believe in too much, if you believe too much to these things, maybe you go crazy or something, you know. But there's a lot of interesting things for people to find. So I don't think like you find Christianity or something, Jesus in my song, something like that. But that's not like what it is. It's not a striper. You know, just a philosophy or something like that.
Spiritual.
Spiritual. Yeah.
Key.
Key.
Yeah.
Key.
今年になってから考え方変わったっていうのはどういうところで、なぜ変わったんですか？
It changed by drinking. This is true, actually. I mean, I was drinking so much last year. I drove myself to a point where I collapsed, actually, you know, both mentally and physically. And this made me, I actually went to the hospital for one day, you know, for this. And then I went to see some of the places where I was living when I was like younger, you know, like 10 or so. And there happened some things to me, and this like opened my mind. Because I was like I became like honest, 100%, you know. I was in the far extreme of the everything when I was doing, like extreme. And now I'm finding the balance more. But this like opened my mind, you know. I was taking myself so far with drinking, I think, and other things.
Not a good thing, yeah.
No, but it was a good thing, because if that made me realize everything, and then it was a good thing. You
know? なるほど。その、今話戻りますけど、その変わったことが今回のスタートバレスのデスティニーには映し出されているということですね。
I think it will be reflected in the next one, because these songs were like written before, or in that time actually when it was happening. So it may be more than it will be more in the next record. You know, nobody knows what it will be. Something really big.
この SOS のビデオはとてもユニークで、コンセプトに基づいて作られているそうですけど、そのビデオのシューティングの時のエピソードとか、そのコンセプトについて、ファンにちょっと教えてもらいたいんですけど。
That's the concept is entirely being discovered by the director of the video. We have nothing to do with that. He had free hands. So there are these choir boys singing on Destiny Records. So he took those choir boys like to one countryside in Finland. Like, there was one church, I think, and then they like try to go to this church, these boys, and they can't go because it's locked, and then they go to some other place, and then there are like two evil guys. And one is like two meter tall, like really big guy, and it's like a lot of things going on.
I haven't seen it yet, so yeah, I can't comment. Seen
it. He will see it today.
Yeah.
It's a different video as well.
まあ、いつも日本にプロモーションでティモ・トルキとティモ・コツペルトの2人がねやってきまして、まあ今回はキーボード奏者のイェンス・ヨハンソンというなんか色合いが違って、なんかストラトバリウスのメンバーのキャラクターというのがねいつもと違う感じで広がったように僕はインタビューしながら思ったんだけど、皆さんはどうだったでしょうか？ さあ早速 SOS を見ていただこうと思うんですけど、これは SOS っていうのは Save Our Souls、 結構いかにもねティモ・トルッキらしいディープな歌詞の内容のようなんですけど、これが撮られた教会というのは以前ビジョンズの時にフォトセッションを行われた教会で、これはヘルシンキの郊外にある教会内容ですね。善と悪との戦い、無垢な少年たちと、そして悪魔、まあ、描写もなかなかね、コントラストがはっきり分かれている映像ですよ。ストラトバリウス SOS。